differential ring gear installation. Some ring gears are an interference fit, and they have to be heated up. Here I'm going to use my sonic cleaner. Heated up around 150 to 200 degrees Fahrenheit. Put it in there for about 15 to 20 minutes. That will expand it enough to easily install onto your ring gear case. The ring gear is in the basket, and I'm going to use gloves to remove it. Place the ring gear down on the bench. Quickly dry it off. You must work quickly so that you don't lose the heat and the expansion of the ring gear. Now place the case over the ring gear. Carefully align the bolt holes as you raise the ring gear onto the case, making sure you're using your gloves because it is hot. Once the ring gear is seated, get a couple of bolts started. This will ensure that the ring gear does not move out of place. Snug them up with your ratchet. Ring gears must be put in with a Loctite. Here we're going to use a high-strength red Loctite. Place a small amount on each thread. Doesn't take much. After applying a little Loctite to the bolt, I'm going to use a paint marker to put a dot on that bolt so I will know which ones I have Loctited. Continue to Loctite all of the other bolts and place paint markers on each bolt so you can keep track. Remember, you only need a little bit. Now remove the bolts that you used to hold the ring gear in place so you can Loctite those as well. I will snug the last four bolts up with an electric impact gun. Make sure that you set the torque very low so it just snugs them up. Now, the bolt torque on this particular ring gear needs to be measured. The torque is based upon the length of the bolt. Here the bolt is 7/8 of an inch, or 875 thousandths of an inch. We will consult the manual or the specification guide. These bolts are 3/8 of an inch by 7/8 of an inch long. The torque specification is 55 to 60 foot-pounds of torque. Apply the last bit of thread locker to the final bolt. Secure the case in a bench vise. making sure not to damage any of the bearings. We're going to use a two-step method when torquing this ring gear. First, we're going to torque it at half the amount, which is 30 foot-pounds. Then, we'll follow up with the final torque at 60 foot-pounds, making sure to crisscross every time we tighten a bolt. When you tighten, make sure to pull evenly and smooth. This ensures the most accurate torque setting. Finally, change the torque to the final torque of 60 foot-pounds. And finish off your torque, making sure to pull consistently with a nice, smooth, even motion. This will ensure the most accurate torque for each bolt.